the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends, and I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. Going places that I've
good
never
morning,
been.
Good morning, everybody, on this wonderful Tuesday, January 23rd. Hope you guys are still enjoying your restful vacation. I know I am. I hope you're enjoying spending all that time with your family and taking a break from the regular routine. Of course, never taking a break from Torah mitzvot, because learning Torah and doing mitzvot never ever end. And I hope that you'll show us by filling out your Chachmei Hillel mitzvah cards. Oh, hang on 1 second. We're getting a phone call. Let's see. We'll pull over. See if we can take this call. Hang on a second. Let's pull over. Here's a good spot. Let's pull in right here. All right, let's see who it is. Hey, Rabbi Mizrahi, how's it going? You're enjoying your vacation, I hope.
Hey, Rabbi B. First of all, I want to say you're looking fantastic. Whatever you're doing, absolutely keep it up because you look great. These parashiyot, of course, deal with the makot. The last plague, Makat Bechorot, Moshe Rabbeinu goes to Paro, and after Hashem tells him that the plague is going to happen, Bach Asot, at exactly midnight, Moshe proceeds to tell Paro it's going to happen Kechasot, which means around midnight. So why did Moshe Rabbeinu change the word that Hashem told him, and he said Kechasot? So Rashi brings a famous explanation. I saw the Orachim HaKadosh brings a very interesting answer. He says that during the 15th of Nisan at Chatzot, which is when the plague of Makat Bechorot happened, it wasn't the first great event that happened on this date and time. And actually, Abraham Avinu, when he fought the infamous four kings, when they kidnapped Lot, and he had an unbelievable victory against them, that also happened on the 15th of Nisan at Chatzot as well. And it was on that day where all these four kings, they had horrible ideas, horrible beliefs, anti-Hashem beliefs, idolatrous beliefs. And on that day, Abraham Avinu destroyed these kings. But not only did he destroy these kings physically, but he also destroyed their ideologies and their beliefs, and he showed Hashem in the world. And what Moshe was telling Paro is Kechasot, that this midnight is going to be like that midnight. Just like that midnight on the 15th of Nisan, Abraham Avinu came and he destroyed and he vanquished all these terrible beliefs against Hashem. So too on this day you'll see that Hashem is one, Hashem is everything, and all your terrible ways and philosophies, your Egyptian philosophies, are going to be absolutely vanquished and going to be pulverized into nothing. That's the Kechasot, that this midnight will be like that midnight. May we see soon in our days, especially during these terrible times, a Kechasot, a same miraculous midnight that happened then and then before. May we see all our enemies be vanquished, not just physically, but spiritually as well. Enjoy the rest of your vacation. All the best.
Well, thanks a lot, Rabbi Mizrahi. That was a beautiful message, and you enjoy the rest of your vacation. We'll see you when you get back. And we'll see you guys next time on Torah on the Road. In the meantime, I got to get back on the road.
On the road again. Like a band of gypsies, we go down the highway. We're the best of friends, insisting that the world keep turning our way. And our way is on the road again. I just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends.